Hi there, Jamie here today at Teachers Tech. Hope you're having a great day today. The other day I had someone ask me about what was the difference between a relative versus absolute cell reference in Microsoft Excel. Actually, they didn't ask it like that. They asked, why is there dollar signs around some cell references and not around others? So what I mean, here's a formula. If I look at this cell reference right here, when it has a dollar sign around it like this, this is absolute. So I have another formula over here and it doesn't have any dollar signs. So this is going to be, the cell's going to be relative in that case. And I want to show you the difference of what each one does here today on Teachers Tech. So if you want to follow along with today's tutorial, I'll put a link to this sheet down below in the description. You can click on it, make a copy, or download it to your computer. But let's get started here with relative versus absolute cell referencing in Microsoft Excel. And we're going to create a simple formula here to show totals here. And I'm going to start actually with a relative one, and then I'll kind of show the difference between what the absolute will do here. So simple formula here, I'm just going to start with an equal sign here, and the total is going to be this right here, and it's going to be plus this spot. And we don't have anything in the bonus yet, so I know it's going to be the exact same number, but when we do the bonus, then this number over here, this total, will adapt to that. So now what I'm going to do is just copy this down, and I'm just going to double click on that little green square there, and it copies it all the way down. So that is relative. So what that means is if I look in the next cell here, so the first cell was B2 plus C2, that's what I created. As I copied it down, it went moved down with it. So it's relative, B3 plus C3. And then I can look at the next one here. If I click on the next one, it's B4 plus C4. So it's moving down across, and this works great. Now, if I wanted to do the bonus to this cell right here, I can't do the same thing, unless 3.8% was all the way down. So what I mean by this is we're going to create a relative one here. So if I go ahead and hit equals, it's going to be this here, and I'm going to multiply it by the bonus amount, which is 3.8%. So if I hit enter, well, that looks fine. So B2 plus E2, this is still relative. If I copy this down, so I'm just going to double click on this. Notice it works well for the first one, but then nothing was working for the rest of them. Because what's happened is it's moving down. If I look at this cell right here, now it's saying B3 and E3. So this is correct. It moved down to do B3, but E3 is this blank. And if I look at the next one down here, it says B4 and E4. So it's moving down. I need to lock this one in place. So this is in E2, and it's always going to be E2, so I need to make that absolute. And that's where the dollar signs come into it. Now, we can do this a few different ways. I'm not going to delete this. I'm just going to modify this up here in the formula bar, and I'm just going to put some dollar signs around it. You can see. So if I put the dollar sign in here like so, and I'm going to put one after the two here and just hit return. I need to recopy this down, and I'm just going to do that by double click. And look how it all fills in here, because now if I look at the next one, you can see that it's B3 plus E2 up here. And this one is staying in place. So this is absolute. When I put the dollar signs around, it locks it in place there. So that would be kind of the difference. We don't always need to put the dollar signs around all of them. So here's an example. If I was just getting rid of the two, here, the dollar sign in front of the two, and I'm going to actually hit return here. I'm going to go back up to this one and change this one. So I'm going to just get rid of the two here, the dollar sign in front of the two, and then I'm going to copy this one down, just like I did before, and it doesn't work. So if I look at this and think, well, what's wrong with this one? So it's the E is locked in here, but as it's moving down, it's going to, the two wasn't locked in, so it's going 3, 4. You can see how it keeps moving, E6, E7. But if I go back up to it and I'm going to change the dollar signs around here, I'm going to delete this one and then put the dollar sign in this spot, hit return, and copy this one down. Everything looks correct. Now, if I look now at each one, notice it's not moving because I'm not moving. If I was moving across this way, then it would start to change. But since I'm just moving down like this, it's locking it in place. So a different way you can do this, and I tend to use F4 instead. So what I mean, I'm going to delete this here, this dollar sign. And if I go up to this, and I'm just going to click in this right up here. And if I use F4, and remember, depending on your keyboard, if you have to hold down function F4, but if it's just F4, I go ahead and select F4. And you can see that it adds dollar signs around in front of the letter and the number. If I press it again, it goes to the number in front of the number, so it will lock that in. And if I press it one more time, it goes to the letter, and one more time just eliminates both of them. So F4 is a handy way to simply put those dollar signs to make it an absolute value right away. And I tend to use that more than just putting the dollar signs in. But either way, it doesn't take too long. So I hope you like this tip here today about absolute versus relative. And hopefully this makes sense to you when to use either of them. Let me know in the comments if this makes sense. Thanks for watching this time on Teacher's Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.